Rock Archive have customers as far afield as China, but an unexpected interest in their work surfaced closer to home from Russian billionaire and massive music fan Roman Abramovich, who had built himself the perfect intimate live venue underneath Chelsea Football Club. Designed by House of Blues specialist Jim Caffarelli, the bespoke stage, PA and acoustics of Under the Bridge would be complemented with the cream of rock photography. 6 months and 10,000 Rock Archive source pictures later, Abramovich and Caffarelli had chosen their 150 favourite images of British rock. We had a sneak peek with legendary rock critic Paul Morley.
You can come in here and you can get probably more information about what's happened the last 40, 50 years through the way that people are off stage, on stage, posed, not posed, spontaneous moments, not spontaneous moments, about what's actually happened. The images that have come along with it, as we've gone along, I think have become more and more important, almost more important than the music itself, actually, because it's that thing you notice now that it drained away, if you like, the accumulative context that, of which rock photography, pop photography was so important in terms of explaining the story as it went along, in terms of the changes in the people making the music, and capturing them, seeing them in their off-duty moments, in their private moments. The context of popular music is the most important thing, and that those around it that created the images and the designs and the atmosphere seem to have contributed to what the thing was. Matt Bonham was the first pop star I ever fell in love with, and it reminds me of why I fell in love with them. They're not doing much, they just sat around, but it's just the clothing they wear, the green of the grass, the bongo drum hanging behind, it just does that thing that I realise now what the rock photograph did. It just took you into another universe, another reality. And that does seem to be like another reality. And the whole thing about this gallery is that it just seems to be next to each other, all these little windows into these other universes. So, you know, Mark, as he should be, is under Susie. And that's, you know, there's probably a few years apart, but in another sense, there's centuries apart and there's no time apart. And funny enough, I go up to date a little bit. There's a really dreadful photograph of Coldplay here that, to me, summarises how the context of the music has sort of drained away a little bit. You know, they don't seem really have much to say or much to see. They don't seem to have been anywhere. They don't seem to be going anywhere. And this picture of the Who at the top, you know, you can't see the Who, you just see a lot of space and a guitar. And then underneath you've got Polly Harvey. And there's something about that. I wouldn't like to have any Queen records in my life, but I'd love to just have that photograph. You know, the Pet Shop Boys, a classic example of a band that made their own legend, understood how to write their own legend, and understood that a photograph was a really important part of writing that legend. Just extraordinary, the Sex Pistols one, where in fact, you know, they're not being a group as such, they're just being four guys walking down the street, but they immediately dominate everything, you know. You can see they're up to something. That's a great mind, you can just see, and you can see it just in the way he is, in the way that people are beginning to look. You get the feeling that they do belong together. I think it's sometimes to do with the legs. That's what I talk about with the silhouette, you know. And I'd probably look at that photograph a lot longer than I would end up playing the Sex Pistols songs.